Hey, how you doing? Nuova lezione del videocorso gratuito per la scuola di lingue Piccadilly. Io sono Ruggero e oggi parliamo di get. Si tratta di un verbo che crea diverse difficoltà perché non ha soltanto un significato, ma i suoi significati principali sono ben sette. Abbiamo arrivare, prendere, comprare, ricevere, capire, diventare oppure ottenere. Per ricordarli meglio ho inserito qui delle immagini da associare a ogni significato. Il primo quindi receive, ricevere. Il secondo arrive, arrivare. Il terzo buy, comprare. Il quarto obtain, ottenere. Il quinto understand, capire. Il sesto become, diventare, e l'ultimo significato take, ovvero prendere. Il primo esercizio che vi propongo consiste nell'abbinare ciascuna frase con il significato che get esprime in quel determinato contesto. Ad esempio, nella frase A, how do you get to work? Il significato di get è arrive. Quindi l'abbinamento dovrebbe essere A6. Per poter avere il tempo di svolgere questo esercizio, potete mettere il video in pausa e poi andare a controllare le soluzioni che trovate, come al solito, nei commenti al video. In questo esercizio invece dovrete trovare i verbi che possono essere sostituiti da get. Ho scritto un'email alla mia amica inglese Amy, email in cui racconto la mia esperienza a Londra. Leggerò questa email due volte, la prima volta così come la vedete, quindi non utilizzando get ma i suoi sostituti. Mentre invece la seconda volta leggerò la stessa email sostituendo get ai suoi sinonimi. Dear Amy, how are you? Last month I bought a ticket to London and left for the UK 1 week later. When I arrived there, it was of course raining. Luckily, the flat where I was staying had all the motcons, so I found an umbrella and took it. The city was great, with its red double-decker buses and phone boxes, its parks and museums. Something struck me in particular, an ancient historical building in the heart of the capital. I really wanted to visit it, but to obtain a ticket, you needed to be a member of the Royal Society. I really didn't understand why. Just as I was leaving, however, I received a message on my phone. It was my landlord sending me a pass to the most interesting sites in London, including the one I wanted to see. He had become a member of the Royal Society 2 years earlier. What an exciting experience. I can't wait to go back to England. Drop me a line, Ruggero. Dear Amy, how are you? Last month, I got a ticket to London and left for the UK 1 week later. When I got there, it was of course raining. Luckily, the flat where I was staying had all the motcons, so I found an umbrella and got it. The city was great, with its red double-decker buses and phone boxes, its parks and museums. Something struck me in particular, an ancient historical building in the heart of the capital. I really wanted to visit it, but to get a ticket, you needed to be a member of the Royal Society. I really didn't get why. Just as I was leaving, however, I got a message on my phone. It was my landlord sending me a pass to the most interesting sites in London, including the one I wanted to see. He had got a member of the Royal Society 2 years earlier. What an exciting experience! I can't wait to go back to England. Drop me a line, Ruggero. Anche per questa lezione è tutto. Spero che la lezione vi sia piaciuta. See you next time. Goodbye.